Hello Boss Babes and bosses out there. So in this video, I'm going to share with you on how to create a social media analytics report for your client. So basically, I will just share to you on how I do mine and how my interns doing social media analytics report for me. So hope you will learn something from it. But before I'm going to dive in, for those who are new here, I'm Susie and I create contents about work from home, productivity, self-development, and freelancing lifestyle. So if you like all those kind of topics, please don't forget to subscribe to my channel and hit the bell button down below so that you'll get notified every time I upload a new video. So for you guys na mga aspiring social media managers or mga beginners pa, maybe you don't know what's social media analytics reports. So basically, ito lang yung report na ibibigay mo kay client para malaman niya if nag-grow ba yung social media accounts niya. Kung meron bang new followers, ano ba yung reach, ano ba yung impressions, yung engagements, ano ba yung best time to post, anong kind of content to post, something like that. You should know kung ano yung goal ng client mo. Is it for awareness or is it for conversions? Meaning, iba kasi yung content na mga gagawin mo kung for awareness yung gusto niya. So, that's why it's very important na makita niyo talaga yung analytics and how your content works to your audience. So, if ever awareness yung gusto niya, like meaning gusto lang ni client na maging aware ang mga tao about sa business niya or sa mga services niya, sa mga products niya, or sa brand niya, that is for awareness. Maybe you can look for impressions, engagements, reach, and followers. Pwede yun yung mga lagay mo sa report. But if ever ang gusto ni client is to get leads or magkaroon ng purchase, yung website niya or yung page niya, yung mga ganun, and maybe you are running ads for him or her, then it would be good if you can add sa report mo yung mga ad spend, yung mga CPC, which we call cost per click, or CPL, cost per lead, yung mga ganun. Nakikita yan siya sa yung business manager if gumawa kayo nun sa previous natin ng mga tutorials. I gave you a tutorial on how to create a business manager where you can run ads from there. I will create a tutorial right now. Ipapakita ko sa inyo kung paano siya gawin. We will just do kung ano yung mga usual na sinesend sa client kung ang main purpose is just for awareness. So, yeah. That's that. Kung nagtatanong kayo what are the tools that you needed for you to create, just mainly super simple lang. Ako, hindi ako gumagamit ng mga third-party platforms or third-party tools to get the analytics. Ginagamit ko na is the insights na nasa Facebook and yung insights sa Instagram. By the way, we are going to focus here now sa Facebook and Instagram. Yung mga screenshots din, ilalagay nyo. It's up to you if gagawin nyo siya sa Google Slides or Canva. For me, I prefer doing it sa slide presentation because the purpose naman dito is just to let the client know kung ano na yung progress sa social media niya. That's the most important thing. But it's up to you if you want to go beyond. You can use something na mas comfortable kayo using. You can also put it sa Google Doc if you want and just save it as PDF. So, I'll give you a sample work ng mga interns ko kasi they are handling my Boss Up PH na page and yung Boss Up PH na Instagram. So, the difference between the reach, impressions, and engagement. Ang reach, ito yung unique followers na nakakita sa content mo. If A, B, and C nakakita sa isang content mo, ang makakount niya na reach is 3. Yung impression naman, ito yung ilang times nakita yung content mo, regardless kung unique person ba siya or unique account ba siya or hindi. So, example, si person A nakakita sa content mo twice, and then si person B nakakita ng content mo thrice, and si content C nakakita ng content mo 1. Ang reach niya is 3, pero ang impression niya is 6. 2 plus 3 plus 1. So, yan yung difference between reach and impression. So, ang engagement naman, ito yung how many, kung clinic ba yung post mo, kung nag-like ba, kung nag-engage ba, meaning nag-comment, or kung may nag-share ba. So, yan yung engagement. So, for example, hindi kasi lahat ng mga tao na nakakakita sa post mo is magla-like, mag-click, mag-comment, i-share. So, kung CA nakita niya, pero wala naman siyang ginawa, it means zero engagement for A. And then for B, kung nakita niya yung content mo, tapos nag-comment siya, nag-like siya, and chinare niya, therefore, there are three engagements. Si C naman, nag-like lang. So, you have four engagements for that particular content. So, yan yung bilangan ng numbers. So, at least alam niyo na kung ano yun. And we can now proceed sa screen ko so that I can share to you on how to basically get all the data na kailangan nyo para isend nyo sa client nyo. I will be showing to you the works of my interns for my social media account. So, if you can see anything na posted sa social media ko, 80% niyan mga interns ko yung gumagawa. Again, awareness yung gusto ko nito, awareness yung goal ko, and not conversion. So, this is for week 3, August 17 to 2020. So, basically, ito yung mga makikita nyo na layout. First, makikita nyo na yung mga followers count, ano yung mga published post. It's up to you if you are going to include this one. But for me, pinapasali ko siya. Top 3 to 5 posts for reach and engagement, for stories, best days and time to post, demographics of your audience. Mostly from the Philippines yung audience ko, so hindi ko na to siya pinapakuha. What works and what didn't, and yung action plan based on the number 7. So that's that. So ito yung mga published content. That's the sample of the published content. As you can see, my date kung kailan siya nag-upload, my caption, my picture. So this one is an informative image. This is a service promotion. Now, pupunta na tayo sa followers count. Ito na yung followers count. If you can see, we gained 85 followers. And for the likes, we gained 82 likes for 1 week. So, maybe you are asking saan ko yan siya makikita. So, just go to your Facebook page and then go to Insights. Here, makikita mo sa loob, may overview siya. Ito yung overview, again, before kayo mag-start, kung it's your first time to handle the account, don't forget to screenshot the overview so that you will know kung may progress ba before kayo nag-handle at saka nung kayo na yung nag-handle ng account. So, this one, followers, dito mo siya makikita kung anong date. September 10, ito yung followers. At ngayon, currently, September 24, we have 1,290, ano na. Tapos, i-compute nyo na lang siya to get the exact followers na na-gain. Pwede kayong makatrack dito. For example, gusto nyo lang from September 1 to September 24 yung makita. From September 1 to September 24. You can manipulate. Pwede ding exact 1 month. Pwede ding exact 1 quarter. 1Q. 1 quarter. And then, pwede nyo siyang screenshot and then ito yung ilagay nyo. Kino-compute lang nila yung before and then, yun na yung total gain. So, that's that. Dito na tayo sa 3. Top post. Paano siya kukunin yung mga top post? So, here, go to post lang. And then, dito sa baba, makikita mo dito kung ano yung reach and engagement, ano yung pinakamataas. Let's say, gusto ko ng September, starting September 1 to September 24 until now. You can just backtrack here. Ang pinakamataas so far, 1-1, tapos mayroon ding 1K. That's for the reach, okay? So, ikiklik lang, for example, tignan natin to. Tapos, for the month of September, ito yung pinakamalaki. 18 shares, 26 shares. Mag-screenshot ka lang, tapos yan na yung ilagay mo dito sa post. As you can see, itong data nito is ito. So, that's how you are going to get the details for the reach. The next, that's top 1, top 2, top 3, top 4. Sa engagement naman, kasi iba-iba yung reach and engagement. So, for the engagement, for example, this one, just the same. Let's say, September 1 to 24. Titignan ko lang dito kung ano yung mga pinakamataas. And yan yung ipopost ko. Basically, mostly ito yung mga pinakamataas. This one, this color, is for clicks and this one is for reactions. Clicks, ang dami. 414, 180 yung nag-react. So, let's click that. And then, you can screenshot this one. And then, yan din yung ilalagay niya dito. And also, para makuha nyo kung ano yung best time to post, dito yan siya. As you can see, best days dito, as of this time is, ito, Wednesday, Tuesday, and Monday. Ito yung best days. And then, ang best times, itong 6 a.m. from here, 4 a.m. and then to 6 a.m. and here then, mag-start na naman siya. Mag-peak sa 10 p.m. tapos super peak niya 11 p.m. So, ganun. You can also screenshot this one para makita ni client kung ano yung best days. This one, ito. Ito yung ginawa nila. Best days and time to post. And then, for the stories, ito yung stories. Saan makikita ang stories? Here, na sa gilid lang. Click stories. And then, ito yung makikita. We have, as of now, makikita niyo to last 28 days. We have 163 unique opens, and then stories published, and then engagement. If you also want to know your demographics when it comes to your story openers, story viewers, ito, dito mo siya makikita. And then, ito yung analytics. Ilan yung nag-open, ilan yung nag-engage. If you want to get the top 3 to 5, you can backtrack it here and click mo lang siya. You can screenshot and put it here. Hindi ko na siya pinakuha sa mga interns ko kasi hindi naman ako sobrang active. Hindi kami sobrang active when it comes to stories. Here naman, meron pa tayong nakalagay dito na isa na demographics for your audience. This is optional, but maybe your client want to get the demographics, meaning saan nakatira, anong age mostly na nag-open or nag-engage. So, dito nyo makikita yan sa people na menu. So, basically, yung fans nyo, ito yung demographics. You can click see more, pero hindi naman necessary na lahat talaga. Kahit yung mga top 5 lang. You can screenshot this one here. Sari natin to. Just the top 5. Pwede nating i-ano na lang dito. Isagad. And then, you can put something like this. Make sure that this is a people. And this is under fans. Ito yung demographics niya. This is the top 5 cities. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. For the countries, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. And ito yung pinakamataas. Yan. Mostly, hindi ko na ito pinapakuha sa interns ko kasi alam ko naman na from most of it are from the Philippines. Demographics. Something ganyan. Pero, kung ako sa inyo, ang kukunin ko is yung people reached and people engaged. Kasi ito yung mas sila yung nag-i-engage talaga or sila yung nakakakita sa mga post nyo. So, I would highly recommend that you should get this instead. And then the last thing, the important, is what works and what didn't. So, dito nyo malalaman or dapat dito kayo makaka-realize kung ano yung mga nag-work na mga content na mga ginawa nyo, ano yung mas maraming nakaka-relate, ano yung mga content na mas maraming nagla-like, nag-share. So, dyan magbabase yung action plan nyo. So, everything that you can see na nag-work, ilagay nyo dito. At kung everything na feeling nyo, reason why hindi siya nag-work, ilagay nyo dito. So that you can base your action plans sa mga realizations nyo for the week. And you can create another action plan para sa social media ng clients nyo or sa social media accounts nyo. So for this one, mainly ang nilagay lang is post about virtual assistants, informative contents like tools and strategies, topic that is relatable to aspiring and newbie freelancers, motivational post, talk something that you are also struggling with, and making sure to have a clear CTA call to action to every post. So yan lang yung necessary talaga, usually na nilalagay sa social media analytic reports. And now, let's proceed to Instagram. Now, for the Instagram, basically, just the same yung mga data na kailangan natin kunin. Just basically the same. Maybe I'm going to teach you now paano nyo siya gawin. So, here's the tutorial on how you can go through with the analytics naman sa Instagram. First, ito yung followers. As you can see, kinuha niya dito yung before and tsaka on this end of the week. Makikita mo yung difference. Dito, kung titignan mo siya, we have 256 followers. And then dito na, nag-increase na siya, 307 na. So, sa growth, overall 32, mayroong nag-unfollowed, 2. Followed you, 34. So, therefore, 34 sa mga followers pero may nag-unfollow na 2, kaya last 2, kaya ang overall is 32. So where can you see that? Just go to your Instagram account. So ito yung boss up. And then click niyo lang tong nasa taas, may tatlong lines dyan. And then click insights. And then here sa insights, makikita mo dito yung overview. Accounts reached, content interactions, total followers, and then ito yung mga na-share nyo. So, just go to total followers if you want to get the followers count, and then pwede nyo ito siyang ma-screenshot. You can also, if you're going to browse sa baba, you can see kung ano yung mga demographics, kung saan kadalasan yung mga followers and audience nyo for the Bosta PH. For the countries, you can just click here na sa gilid. Philippines, United States, United Kingdom, India, Canada. That's that. For the age range naman, 25 to 34. For men, just the same. So yan, meron din tayong gender. Mas marami ang mga babae kasi sa mga lalaki. So probably yan din yung ratio and proportion sa mga gustong matutong mag-online job, because this is all the content of this account is more on freelancing. And then you can also get here the most active times ng mga followers nyo for Thursday, Friday, Saturday. And then for the days, most active time, you can tap the blue shapes para makita niyo yung counts. Kasi kung hindi niyo siya itap, mawawala yung numbers. Pag itap niyo siya, magkakaroon siya ng numbers para mas madali niyong ma-determine kung saan yung pinaka mataas. So, ayun, dyan niyo siya makikita. Yan yung mga kinukuha namin na details. So, for the next one is itong mga published. Okay, so for example, saan to nakikita yung mga post na to? Makikita yan siya. Just go to here. Click something sa mga na-publish nyo na. And then view insights. Yan. And then if you can drag that, everything will be displayed. Profile visit, follows, impressions, mga ganyan. For this one, I have questions for you. This is for day 2 ng 11. That's how you are going to get the details dito sa gilid. And then, to get the top post, click here. And then, insights. Tapos, dito kayo sa accounts reach. And then, dito kayo sa top post. Again, this is just for last 7 days ha. Pwede niyo siyang select kung ano yung post type. Kung by follow ba yung gusto niyo, impressions and reach, or save or shares. For me, I prefer to get the reach and the impressions for Instagram. So, for example, reach yung gusto ko. Let's say for the last 7 days. So, ang pinakamataas is itong, ang top 1 ko is itong how to land a client. Ito yung first post ko, tapos click ko lang tong post insights and then drag ko siya pataas and then screenshot this one. So, makikita mo dito may 4 profile visits tayo, may 7 saves, 1 comment. Ang reach is 168, therefore, there are 168 unique people na nakakita sa reach. Ang impressions is yung how many times nakita yung itong content na to sa ibang tao. Screenshot this one and pwede niyo siyang malagay dito sa gilid. For the stories naman, let's go back here. Ito yung top stories. Let's say, gusto ko lang ng 7 days. So, there are 49 people na nakakita nito. So, this will be my top 1. Top 1, top 2, top 3, top 4, top 5. Pwede this one. Ito na yung screenshot nyo all in all. For the top 5 stories, pwede siyang ma-top 5 stories. Pwede din siyang ma-top 3. It's up to you. And then, ito sa mga post to siya. Ito yung top 5. Ito yung mga top post when it comes to reach, impressions, profile visits, follows, engagements. Again, the client will ask or you decide, depende kung ano yung goals niya. Is it awareness or conversion? And then you can also go here sa content interactions. You can also go here to get some data. Ito yung mga sinabi ko sa inyo kanina. Just go to followers and then sa pinakababa andito lahat yung mga most active times. So again guys, nag-iiba-iba yung update ng Instagram. So maybe next month or next year, baka nag-iba na naman yung user interface ng Instagram. Pero basically, the same lang din naman yan. Meron lang mga small changes. So yeah, after that, the same pa rin. What works and what didn't? Dito, in-explain lang niya na other things that worked well. Kasi dito pa lang nagsistate na siya kung ano yung nag-work. In terms of reach and impressions, informative post that contains list works well. Dito naman, in terms of profile visits and follows, marketing quotes, boss of freelancer, testimonials and tips worked well as this post captured attention of the audience and made them visit or follow the page. Other things that worked well, following, engaging, sharing post target audience. Ito yung may sample na parang ang target kasi namin ng mga ano dito, mga entrepreneurs, mga coaches for Instagram. Our content focus more on giving values to entrepreneurs and coaches. So, that's that. This is a win because may mga nag-follow na coach talaga. Therefore, they are our ideal clients. So, this one, what didn't work? Yung hashtags. The same yung hashtags na ginamit namin. So, that's why there are also the same niche. On our the same niche, like mga digital marketing branded and mga social media managers din. So, since we are using the same hashtags, that's why nakaka-attract din tayo ng the same ng mga followers. So, it's okay lang naman. No worries for that. Pero, we can change the set of hashtags to get more ideal clients rather than the same na mga niche ng mga service provider. So, here again is the action plan, following and engaging with audience, add another set of hashtags, teaser type post, something like that. So, ito yung plan for the next week. That's pretty much that. There's really nothing fancy. I hope you enjoy that and I hope you learned something from this. And let me know if you have any questions when it comes to social media analytic reports on the platforms that I have discussed. Thank you so much. So that's basically it. Nothing's fancy. Ang importante lang talaga, malaman ni client kung ano yung mga content na nag-work sa social media niya, ano yung mga demographics, ano yung kailangan pang mas i-improve, ano yung mga kailangan pang strategy na ma-implement or campaign na kailangan yung i-run para mas maganda yung reach, impressions, and engagements, and of course, conversions kung kailangan ng conversions ni client. And basically then, yan lang din yung mga necessary na data na kailangan yung kunin sa other social media platforms like Twitter. Other social media managers may provide other analytic data sa clients nila. You can also learn from them kung ano pa yung kailangan. But for me, my clients are mostly happy with all those kind of info. So before I'm going to end this video, I'm going to flex with you the works of my boss babes and bosses inside my group. Check this out. If you want to join our Facebook group, you can just search I'm Ready to Boss Up by Brick Sui. You can also like our Facebook page, Boss Up PH, and Instagram account, Boss Up PH, and at Brick Sui. So, yeah, hope to see you guys on my next one. Bye!
Cutie! Bagong gising po si baby Amira namin. Bagong gising po.